I saw this update on my news feed. This Delhi guy, I think his name is Kanta Prasad and his wife Devi. So for those of you who do not know, the backstory was a YouTuber went to this Delhi, it's a small like canteen, a cafeteria, where they serve food. So this old man, as he was serving him food, he started to cry because there was no business, life is tough, he doesn't know how to pay his bills. So this YouTuber, out of the goodness of his heart, took a video saying, as he was crying, and he requested people, please, if any one of you is in Delhi, please come here. See, this man is crying. This is an old man, maybe 60, 70, 80, whatever. And then he opened one of the, utensils which had the food, and he said, see, the food is delicious. Please come, you know, give him some support. Well, he uploaded this on his YouTube channel. I don't know if I can get the link. If I get the link, I'll put it down below. If not, just send it across. So after he put it up, lo and behold, it went viral. Viral, everyone started forwarding it and talking about it. And before you know it, it's like people started coming to support this guy. His business actually increased tenfold, 10 times more. Huh? And not only that, people looking at this man's plight, out of the goodness of their heart, they started donating money. And they donated. So it was a feel-good story. Everyone's happy. Okay. Oh, after a few days, another story popped up. And this time, this old man filed a police case on this YouTuber. And I was like, what? And then when I read the article, it seems that he filed a police case stating that this man used his situation, took a video, and took all his money or whatever money people were donating, he took all of it. And he claimed that there was a lot of money and this guy took everything. Just imagine, see the fun. The guy who helped him gets fucked, okay? And this old man, instead of being grateful that he's getting some help, he demanded, I need to know what are the books of accounts, I need to know how much money is coming, all that money you're getting is mine, I have to get it. I was like, I was not surprised, I was not shocked, because this is the typical mentality of people. This is one of the reasons I do not help people, I do not like to help people, and especially maybe because I'm Indian, I know Indians more. Because I'm Indian, I interact with Indians, I can tell you about Indians. I find Indians disgusting human beings. Not all. The ones who are ungrateful like this. And if you check my previous videos, I'm sure you would have seen those incidents where I literally helped a mother who didn't have money to buy food, whose clothes were torn, was asking for a job. I helped her rebrand herself. I helped her train her for interviews, introduced her to the contacts that I had, literally got her a job and got her husband a job. And then, because I put up an article without stating her name, I put up an article stating that it feels good to help a human being. And I narrated the story of a lady who didn't have any hope, and I helped her. I didn't state her name, I didn't state where she's from, nationality, religion, nothing. This lady, instead of being grateful that I helped her with money, helped her get a job, helped her, trained her, helped her husband get a job, got a fund me account for her children, she, on top of that, started shouting and screaming at me and giving me a peace of mind. Why? She's saying that I spoiled her name in society. I ruined her name. I used her name to become famous. I was so pissed off. In my life, it's very rare I get pissed off. I was so pissed off. I made sure that she lost that job. I informed that guy, the owner, what she did. And he told her, I don't need a ungrateful bitch like her. She lost a job, husband lost a job. The money that was given to her is gone. I didn't bother. I told all my contacts about her. And I can tell you, in less than a month, again, she was back on the streets, and there she apologized and she was begging and this. And I said, I'm not interested. I'll call the police. I told her, I'll call the cops if you call me ever again. So, anyway, back to this guy's story. So when he did that, I was not surprised, but I really felt bad for the YouTuber. Imagine a police case, imagine a court case. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they settled it out of court, or he revealed how much he got. I'm not saying that there are not people who fake, who take other people's story and pocket all their cash. I'm not saying no, but look at the way this old man, his mind works, his brain thinks. Okay. So, okay, that part got over. Now, yesterday, I found this story trending that this guy was back in the headlines. I was like, why? Again, to my shock and surprise, I found out that this guy earned a huge sum of money, huge, massive, through donations and all that. So much money that he closed down that small shop that he had, opened a two-story restaurant, hired staff, hired a cook, hired, bought new items, fridge, this, that, tables, chairs, decorated the place, decked it up, then constructed his house, it means finished whatever pending was there, paid his loans. Oh, jing bang, all the free money. Oh, he was living the dream. And he was a businessman now. Okay. And it seems that less than 1 year, he has to shut down his entire business and go back to that hut, go back to that same old cafeteria. And the reasons he cited is, oh, I was misguided by other people, I was given the wrong advice. And he's still blaming other people. And it seems that he still wants to, take legal action against that guy who gave him bad advice or whatever. And then obviously the Twitter world and online world started talking, and it seems even the minister or something, he chimed in and said, oh, if he wants advice, we can guide him. So now, what do I think? See, these people who are poor, no? Not all, but majority. They are poor because they are meant to be poor. We might look at them with sympathy and pity and poor thing, and they're actually fucking assholes. Most of them are ungrateful. It's not that they're evil human beings. Their mentality is such, it's like they live in a dog-eat-dog world. If you help them, for example, if you help them, in their mind it is, the bastard is loaded, I better take the maximum money from him. That's exactly how they think. These tears are manufactured, it's fabricated, entire thing. It's, these tears that they have, oh, life is so tough and all that. It is not, these are not genuine tears in the sense that, yes, they are tears of pain, but it's for themselves, for their own greed, for their own selfishness. They are evil inside and they cry because they want for themselves. And the minute that they get, that evil, that darkness that is there is still lurking. So the minute the hunger is filled, the minute you give them, reduce their pain, that evil demon still comes out. That is why, that is why I follow policy. I don't help anyone. You want my assistance, pay money. So end of the day, if nothing happens, no hard feelings. Yes, I have made mistakes again and again of helping people. I'm human, you know. Sometimes you feel sorry, and there have been guys, girls, men and women. In the end, only for me to regret, a shit, I did a mistake again. So what is the message I'm trying to tell you through this video? Number one is, like this, you know, you give a man a fish, you have to give him a fish for your entire life. Every time you teach a man to fish, he will fish for himself. Okay, that is one. Now, if you have the time to teach them how to fish, fine. You don't have time, just leave it, man. The second thing is, when you give free money, no, there's no value for it. If you really had to help this guy, I would have said, order food from him, let him work, and you can take the food and distribute to someone else, and he gets his money. That's another way to help. Don't give them big sums of money. It corrupts them. And keep in mind, for people who do not know how to manage money, who have never been rich, they will never know how to manage it. So even if you give them $25,000, $50,000, $100,000, and they only had 25, they will somehow magically spend all that money and come back to 25. That's how they are. You cannot change them. You just cannot change them. And, you know, most important thing is, remember, when you help anyone, don't think the universe is going to come and bless you. Most of the time, after you help someone, you're going to end up with more shit. That's why I prefer to be a bad guy. Don't help anyone. Just want money. Anyone who pays me money, I do a good job. That much I can assure you. I do a good job. I give them their money's worth. That's it. No hard feelings, no emotions. Just it's transactional. So end of the day, you want to leave and go and do your own shit. No hard feelings at all. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know your thoughts. Do you think this guy, this old man, you'll feel sorry for him? Think he's a good guy? He's an ungrateful guy? And what would be your solution to such a human being? Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you. Let me know your thoughts. It's me signing off. Ciao.